Well, I've gotten one request, the overwhelming one request, to show how I fill my pipes and what my method is for putting the tobacco in my pipes. So I thought I would do that with my brand new, excuse me, Peterson. I'm very excited about this bike, first of all. And let me just share a couple things with you. I normally keep my tobacco when I can in a jar like this that is has a seal on it. You can see the rubber here. Just helps with the freshness. I also tend to keep my tobacco in the original bag if it came in a bag, so that I have information about where I got it and what the blend was. I think that's helpful to have. Even when I do put them in jars, like if they came in a tin and I put it in a jar, like I did this one, I take the label off the tin or the can, and I tape it on the jar so I have a record of what's in there. So that's a little how I keep my tobacco. This is English Blend number 1 from Ted's Pipe Shop in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I got this tobacco a while ago, so I will just tell you right off the bat, it's a little dry, and that might make a difference in how I fill it. So just be aware of that. Okay, so a couple different ways I do it. One is what I often do, and this is probably not the best way, is I literally stick my pipe in the bag, and then I use my fingers to just sort of push tobacco in until it feels full, and then I just poke it down in with my finger. And I usually do that until it is full or overflowing. And that's it. And then I maybe push it down with my finger. Maybe sometimes I use my tamper to push it down a little bit. I don't ever make it too tight. And then, can't see that, but I just put it in my mouth to check on the draw. So that's one way to do it. Let me show you another way. And to do that, I will simply empty the tobacco. Just very carefully taking it out with my pipe tool. And I'm going to put that back in the bag so you can see me start all over. So that, quite frankly, very well, let's say it's not the most delicate of ways of filling your pipe. I shove it in with my finger while the pipe's sticking in the bag. That's one way. Another way that I have found is good to fill pipes. I'll do this with my Meerschaum because I don't like to stick it into the bag, especially if the tobacco's a little more moist. I don't want it to stick. I've only had this Meerschaum like a week and a half, but I don't want it to stick to the Meerschaum. I don't know if that's good or bad for it. I just don't like it. So what I've been doing here, and I think this is a method that you can also use, is I put a piece of paper down. You can see I'm on a scrap piece of paper. And I literally just sort of sprinkle it in until it seems full. And then I push down, not too hard. And then I get some more tobacco. In this case, I'm just picking up what fell down. And I sprinkle it in a little more. And push it down. And for me, that would be ready to light. There's a whole different set of theories about lighting pipes, which I won't go into right now, but maybe that's a future video. So for me, that's how I fill my pipes. I either scoop it out of the bag, or if it's not in a bag or a pouch or whatever, I do this method where I dribble it in over a piece of paper and then redribble it in. All right, that's how the Pipe Prof fills his pipes. Maybe it's not the best way, but it works pretty well for me. Cheers.